Welcome all students in our virtual classroom of Municipal Corporation of Greater Mumbai. I am Sonali Shankara Kamre from Varshanagar Mumbai Public School. This is our 6th standard and I am going to take revision on topic as Ancient Kingdoms of the South. Before to start our lessons, we will take a recap. Yesterday we have learned about three dynasties. First one, Chol, Pandya and Chola dynasties. Second one, Satavahana dynasty. And the third one, Vakataka dynasty. In that dynasties, we have learned about their emblem, their representative symbols, their expansion of the regions, again the famous kings, like that. We get the more information about the Gautamiputra Satkarni. Then we have learned about the other kings also. Today we are going to learn about three more dynasties. First one, the Chalukya dynasty. The second one, the Pallava dynasty. And the third one, the Rashtrakut dynasty. Let's begin to learn today's dynasties. The first one, the Chalukya dynasty. The Chalukya dynasty in Karnataka was one powerful. It means that Chalukya dynasty was very powerful in Karnataka. Here, Karnataka. After that, Badami Chalukyas. The earliest Chalukyas with their capital at Badami, it also called as Vatapi in Karnataka. It means that the capital of Chalukya dynasty was Badami, which was present in Karnataka. Jayasimha was the first ruler of the Chalukyas. Here the name is given Jayasimha, the person who was the first ruler of the Chalukya dynasty. After that, Pulkeshi first, who ruled on the region from 543 AD to 566 AD. The Pulkeshi first, who ruled in the Chalukya dynasty in the 6th century CE, common era. The Pulkeshi first, the time period of the ruling in the Chalukya dynasty was in 6th century. Founded the empire with his capital at Vatapi. He founded the empire with his capital at Vatapi. With the capital of Vatapi, he founded his empire in Chalukya dynasty. Let's see about the Pulkeshin II, the king who was ruled in Chalukya dynasty from 609 AD to 642 AD. The greatest of Chalukya's king. It means that among all the kings of the Chalukyas, the Pulkeshin II was the greatest king of Chalukya. Extended the Chalukya rule to most part of the Deccan. Here extended, it means that he ruled or he expanded the ruling area in Chalukya dynasty. And mostly he ruled on the parts of the Deccan. The greatest of the Chalukya's kings. Pulkeshin II defeated Harshvardhan's army at Narmada. Here there is one more one more information is given that the Pulakeshin second defeated. Defeated means in the battle of Pulakeshin second with Harshvardhan's army, that time he defeated to Harshvardhan's army. And where he defeated? He defeated at Narmada. At the place of Narmada, he defeated to Harshvardhan's, the King Harshvardhan's army. See, this is the picture of temple which we known as Badami temple. It was built in Chalukya dynasty. Temple at Pattadakal, the name of place where this temple was built up. And this temple was built up in Chalukya's period or during the Chalukya's dynasty. The famous temple is there. See, this is the map of Chalukya dynasty. The green shaded portion shows the Chalukya dynasty, which was near to the Maharashtra state, then Andhra Pradesh, then Madhya Pradesh. And these are the region of the Chalukyas where the Chalukyas king were ruling over there for a particular time period. Extent of the Chalukya dynasty. Kingdoms of Kalachuri and Kadampam had become powerful after the decline of the Vakatakas. It means the word here is given decline. Decline means decreasing. When the Vakatakas king's power were decreasing, that time what happens? Other kingdoms like Kalachuri and the Kadampa, what happened? They become powerful. See, here is the given Kalachuri, and they again, this is the Chalukya dynasty. When other ruling area or other dynasties were becomes less powerful, that time what happened? Automatically the others kingdoms become powerful. Like here only what happened? When Vakatakas become in decreasing their power, that time kingdoms of Kalachuri and Kadampa had become powerful. Administration and society. The Chalukyas had great maritime power. Here word maritime is given. It means that oceanic power. The power which is related near to the sea or what we say, the place where the water is present. That time the Chalukyas had a great power. They also had a well-organized army. See, Chalukyas have a good, well-organized army. Though the Chalukya kings were Hindus, they were tolerant of Buddhism and Jainism. It means that Chalukya's kings were Hindus, that's why they were tolerant of Buddhism and Jainism. We have learned about the Buddhism, the message of truth and non-violence was given by the Buddhism, and that message and that Buddhism and Jainism were heard by Chalukya kings. Saw great developments in Kannada and Telugu literature. Here we have learned that they developed the literature among two languages, that is Kannada and Telugu. Between two languages, in the two languages, they have developed the literature, that is Kannada and Telugu. Pallava dynasty. Now we are going to learn a new dynasty, that is the Pallava dynasty. There is no clarity on the name of the founder of Pallava dynasty, but the rise of Pallavas in the last quarter of the 6th century. See here, what is given? There is no clarity. It means that there is no any particular name was given. That name shows the founder of the Pallava dynasty. It means that nobody knows that who was the founder of Pallava dynasty. But the rise of Pallavas in the last quarter of the 6th century, here the time period was mentioned, that is rise. Rise means the Pallava dynasty came in which a century, the last quarter of the 6th century. Mahendra Varman first is considered to be the greatest ruler of the Pallavas. It means that among all the Pallavas king, here one name, that is Mahendra Varman first. He was considered to be the greatest ruler of Pallavas. Among all the ruler of the Pallavas, there is one person, there is one king who was so famous, and that king or that ruler was known as Mahendra Varman first. Kanchipuram was the capital of Pallavas. See here, the name of place is given, that is Kanchipuram. Kanchipuram was the capital of Pallavas. Here, if anyone asks you about that, which was the capital of Pallava dynasty, that answer would be the name of it, and it was the capital of Pallava. So temple at Mahabalipuram and the Kailash Nath temple at Kanchipuram are famous temples that were constructed during the reign of Pallavas. See here is mentioned, that is reign. Reign means during the Pallavas period. What happened? There are two important temples were so famous. First one, Mahabalipuram. Short temple at Mahabalipuram, and the second one, Kanchi Kailashnath temple. Both Kanchi temple was present near to the Kanchi temple is present at Kanchipuram. These two famous temples were built up or constructed during the Pallavas dynasty. The extent of the Pallava dynasty, that the Pallava capital was Kanchipuram. We have learned about that Pallava's capital of Pallava was Kanchipuram. After that, their territories at the height of their powers extended from northern part of Andhra Pradesh to river Kaveri in the south. See here, from north to south, what happened? The territories, it means the regions where the Pallavas ruling over that region was extended. It means that that was from northern part of Andhra Pradesh, from Andhra Pradesh northern part to the river of Kaveri in the south. Among these territories, the Pallavas ruler were ruling their regions. Vattapa or Badami was occupied by the Pallava king Narasimha Varman, who defeated the Chalukyas. The Vattapa or Badami was occupied by the Pallava king Narasimha Varman, who defeated the Chalukyas. It means that the king of Pallava, that is Narasimha Varman, that king who defeated the Chalukyas. It means in the battle of the Pallava rulers and with the Chalukyas rulers, that time what happened? Pallava's king Narasimha Varman, he defeated the Chalukyas, the king of Chalukya. See, this is the map where the extension a region of the or territories of the Pallava dynasty was mentioned. That is the blue shaded part shows the Pallava dynasties, and that dynasty was near to the nowadays near to that Karnataka and the Tamil Nadu. Mahendra Varman, the king of the Pallava dynasty, the king of Pallava dynasty, that name is Mahendra Varman. He was a poet and composer. The Mahendra Varman, he was poet also and the composer also. He introduced rock cut temple architecture. See, he introduced a new art, that is rock cut temple architecture. Had ongoing battles with Pulakeshin II of Chalukya dynasty. Mahendra Varman died in battle with the Chalukyas. When battle was happened between the king of Chalukyas with the king of the Pallava dynasty, that time what happened, the king of Pallava dynasty, that is Mahendra Varman, died in battle of the Chalukyas. He was an able and efficient ruler. He was a good ruler. The Rath temples at Mahabalipuram were sculpted in single rock during his reign. Here one word is given, sculpted. It means carving. It means that the Rath temples, the famous Rath temples, which was present in Mahabalipuram, were sculpted in only single rock. There is a speciality of one temple of the Mahendra Varman's ruling time period. That time what happened, under his instruction or during in his reign, what happened, the one famous temple, Rath temples, was built up from only one single rock. See, this is the Rath temple, which was built up during the reign of Mahendra Varman, and it was, the speciality of this temple was, it was sculpted from only single rock. Let's see about the Rashtrakut dynasty. The Rashtrakut dynasty, or the last dynasty of today's lesson, that is the ancient kingdoms of the south. Here the Danti Durga was the founder of Rashtrakut dynasty. The king Danti Durga, who was the founder of Rashtrakut dynasty. Krishna first succeeded Danti Durga. It means that succeeded means after the Danti Durga, who took the position of the Danti Durga, that is Krishna first. He also occupied Konkan. He was ruled over the Konkan also. Krishna first also defeated Vishnu Vardhana of Vengi and the Ganga king of Mysore. See, now after the founder of Danti Durga, the positions of the Danti Durga was taken by the Krishna first, and after that, succeeding to the Danti Durga, what happened? He occupied Konkan, and also he defeated Vishnu Vardhana of Vengi, the name of place, that is Vengi, and that place king Vishnu Vardhan was defeated by Krishna first. and Krishna first also defeated the king of Mysore. The name of king of Mysore was the Ganga. He was a great patron of art and architecture. It means that Krishna first who gives supports to the art and architecture. The Kailash temple at Ellora was built up by the Rashtrakut king Krishna first. Here the particular name is given, the temple of Kailash. The temple of Kailash, which is present at Ellora, it was built up by the Rashtrakut king Krishna first. The famous temple Kailash temple was built up by Krishna first king. Krishna first king, who was the king of the Rashtrakut dynasty. The Rashtrakut dynasty was extended from the Vindhya mountain up to Kanyakumari in the south. See here what is given, the extension area of the Rashtrakut dynasty from Vindhya mountain to up to the south Kanyakumari. From this in that region the Rashtrakut dynasty was extended. See, this is the map of Rashtrakut empire, where this portion shows the extension area or regions of the Rashtrakut dynasties. See here the name Malwa, then Dhar, Era, like that. After the what happened, own the Chalukyas, Gangas and the Cholas, this kind of regions, and they become extended the Rashtrakut in that areas. Let's see what are the recapitulation questions of today's our session. So my first question is that to all 6th standard students, that is, in which period Badami temple was built? This is the easy question. In which period Badami temple was built? The first option is Chalukya dynasty and the second one is the Pallava dynasty. Yes, who will tell the answer of this first question, that is, in which period Badami temple was built? Chalukya dynasty or Pallava dynasty? Is there anyone from the 6th standard students? I have shown the picture of that Badami temple also. Yes. Yes, from the students.
Chalukya dynasty.
Very good, beta. The Chalukya dynasty is the correct answer. In the Chalukya dynasty, the Badami temple was built up. Very nice. The second question, which was the capital of Pallava dynasty?
Kanchipuram.
Very good. Yeah, instant answer given by you, beta. The Kanchipuram was the capital of Pallava dynasty. Very nice. Next question, who was the first ruler of Chalukya dynasty? Yes. Who was the
first?
No, beta, think it again. The first ruler of Chalukya dynasty. Yes. Remember it. I will give option you. That is, first one, Pulkeshin first. Second one, Pulkeshin second. And the third one, Jaisimha. which is the correct answer?
Jayasimha.
Very good, very nice. Jayasimha was the first ruler of Chalukya dynasty. Very good, beta. The last question of today's recapitulation: who was the founder of Rashtrakut? Rashtrakut dynasty is there. Yeah. Who was the founder of Rashtrakut dynasty?
Krishnavan.
King Danti Durga Krishna.
Very good. The king Danti Durga. Very good. Very nice, beta. And after the Danti Durga, who take the position of Danti Durga? Krishna first. Very good. Now let's take assignment questions. First one, write about the achievements of Mahendra Varman. Second one, write a short note on Harshvardhan, the King Harshvardhan. Third one, what do you know about Chalukya kingdom? Fourth one, who carved the Kailas temple? And the fifth one, who was the founder of Rashtrakut dynasty? These are the five questions for the assignment, and write down the answers of these five questions. And in this way, we have completed our lesson, that is Ancient Kingdoms of the South. So thank you to all students.